today we're going to try and melt the wax out of this comb. I had a hive that died, and I read about using steam. This is a steam, like a wallpaper steam creator or a wood steamer thing. It's going to make steam, and I'll show you what I built. Never done this before. We'll see how it works. These frames that I use plastic foundation, which I don't know how they'll do with the heat. We'll find out. It's an experiment. And I also have a few of these full plastic frames that I want to melt down too. Mainly these frames have been in use for about 4 years now. That's about as long as I want the comb to live. You can see they're pretty dark. So we will be building this thing out. So what I've done is I've got a bottom board that I've knocked the edges off, and I've used a level to make sure it's basically level on the ground. I then took a spacer and I knocked some tin here so it has a slope, and then I had a little brass fitting at the end. In theory, the wax will come out. The next thing is I took another spacer and I put some aluminum screen on here to catch any of the cocoon and slum gum material that might fall down, to see that hopefully only the wax and water is going to come down through the screen and then come out this and into this holder. Here's a standard deep brood box that I'll put on top, and I'll put the whole frame in. And then here's the top. The top has a brass fitting on it to let the steam in. It's going to go like this. And then once the steam hooks up, I'm going to hook the steam tube up here, and hopefully melted wax will pour out the bottom. We'll see. It's a big experiment. This is looking down inside the box that's been assembled. You can see the slope to go out the little spigot I built. I didn't really build it on center, so we'll take a frame and put it right toward the middle here. And one of the plastic frames. And this will be our test. You'll see it as it happens. And I've ratcheted the whole thing together to hopefully provide a tight seal between the different levels of the wax melter. The steam's coming out of the hose, so it's time for me to go put it on the fitting, see if this works. 9 minutes in, and look at this. Just wax, bright yellow wax pouring out. Oh, I'm super stoked. It's been about a half hour of the steam. Nothing's really dripping anymore, so I'm gonna crack it open and see what the inside looks like. I'm gonna be some hot steam, so I'm gonna wear my barbecue mitt. Well, look at that. Looks like the plastic frames aren't gonna take it. The plastic frame, steam. The plastic frame is completely melted, and the plastic foundation completely melted too, so it's got the wax, but it's gonna kill the plastic to do it this way. You can see the plastic is really twisted up, so any foundation I put in here, I'm gonna have to just basically replace, which isn't the end of the world. And then inside, you can see the slum gum. This is the cocoon that's left over, very clean. And then the frame itself, looking pretty good. So I think the wax works, the drain works, a little bit of leakage out the sides, but other than that, this step's a good success. So now I'm gonna put some of the wax I store in this old container. It's just straight wax. It's like cappings and stuff, and I'm gonna see how that just straight melts in here. So here's all the wax just resting on the screen. We'll see if it melts next. Wax is just pouring out now. So after about 30 minutes, it's about time to see what's inside. Snooters is quite interested as well. You can see all the wax is melted. It's just slum gum held in the filter. This works really good. Have to decide about what it means about buying all new wax foundations every time I do this. The wax has been cooling overnight, so let's just check it out. There you go. That is a nice big chunk of wax, pretty clean for first refining. Another slightly smaller one, but still really nice. I'll rinse these off, and then I'll probably refine them a few more times to make a cleaner wax, but seemed to work out pretty well. This is the strainer. A lot of slum gum on here. Not too much. It'd be easy to scrape this off, and then the wax collector. Really not a lot extra. I think it worked really well. So I'm pretty happy with this setup. Just need to decide if it's worth melting the plastic foundations to do it this way, or whether I should scrape them and do it another way. So thanks for going along with this experiment with me. After reprocessing one time overnight, here's the wax that came out. 2 pounds of pretty clean wax. Very nice. Happy with the result.